How can we say the Rebbe is Mashiach if the Alter Rebbe said Mashiach will be a Weltische?
I do want to give a disclaimer first that with regards to things like this, explaining what the Alter Rebbe said, I can say a little bit what we said and what we know, but I can't claim to know and understand it fully. Anyone who wants to explain it a different way has always the right to explain it. We can just explain it based on the sources that we have to try and understand what it says. The story went the following. The Alter Rebbe, when he came out of prison after Yutes Kislev, they brought him by mistake, and there's no such a thing as a mistake, everything is Bashgacha Pratis. They brought him to the apartment of someone who was a Seine, who was a big enemy of Chassidus and the Alter Rebbe. And he really pined, he really gave the Alter Rebbe a hard time to the extent that he locked the door. He didn't want to let the Alter Rebbe out. And when he finally did let the Alter Rebbe out, it was on condition, there was one condition that the Alter Rebbe has to meet with three of the Gdolei HaMisnagdim of that time. And the Alter Rebbe kept that condition. And one of the big Rabbanim that the Alter Rebbe met, he asked the Alter Rebbe, will Mashiach be a chassid or a misnagit? Now, maybe even to understand the question, because perhaps it's important to understand that as well. And again, this is my understanding of the question, and no one has to accept it as that is. But one of the big tainus and one of the big complaints of misnagdim against chassidim in that time was the whole idea of Mashiach. The coming of the Baal Shem Tev and the Derech of Chassidus came shortly after the terrible tragedy of Shabsai Tzvi, Yimach Shemayev, the false Mashiach, which caused terrible, terrible, both physical and spiritual suffering among the Jews, not only for that time, but for a long time later. For many, many years, Jews suffered from the aftermath of the terrible calamity of Shabsai Tzvi. When the Baal Shem Tov came along, here came now a new charismatic leader who's talking and revealing Kabbalah and who's talking about Mashiach and who's explaining that his teachings is what's going to bring the coming of Mashiach. And not only that, but it's something which everybody knows, is that Chassidim always turned to the Rebbe as Mashiach. Whether it was the Talmidim of the Baal Shem Tov, whether it was the Talmidim of the Alter Rebbe, Chassidim always said and didn't necessarily make a big secret out of it that their Rebbe is Mashiach. That's not to say that necessarily by the Misnagdim they didn't say about their leaders. At least in that time, the Talmidim of the Vilna Gaon, those who wish to look in Svarim, in early Svarim, such as Kol HaTor and the likes of the Talmidim of the Vilna Gaon, where they very clearly state that he was Mashiach as well. But nevertheless, for most of the world, it was a very big issue what's going on over here. And so perhaps the question, will Mashiach be a chassid or a misnagid, wasn't just a question. It was a question in the whole essence of the thing. You chassidim, you're trying to claim a exclusiveness on the whole idea of Mashiach. What did the Alter Rebbe answer? The Alter Rebbe said Mashiach will be a Weltische. And the Alter Rebbe explained, because if Mashiach will be a chassid, Mashiach has to come for everyone. If Mashiach is a chassid, then the Misnagdim won't accept him. If Mashiach is a Weltische, then everyone will accept him. And the Alter Rebbe continued a very sharp line and said, because chassidim are gleibike, chassidim are believers. And therefore, no matter who Mashiach is, they'll follow him. Misnagdim are not believers. And therefore, unless it's someone that they can relate to, they're not going to follow him. Now, the obvious question on this is that there's no such a thing. A Rebbe doesn't say a gleich vertel. He doesn't just say a nice line. If he's saying it, that's the way it is. And the question, more than just who will Mashiach be, is what does that mean? What, in order for the Misnagdim to follow him, therefore Mashiach will have to be a Misnagit? or a veltische? What? How does one explain that? Mashiach is whoever Mashiach is. So we say it's a special thing of who he's going to end up being in order that we should follow him. It doesn't seem to... Something doesn't sit. Again, if it's a gleich vertel, it's a gleich vertel, but a Rebbe doesn't say a gleich vertel. So perhaps if we'll look to understand it, we have to understand the whole idea of Mashiach and the whole idea of a gleibike, a believer, and a non-believer, and what it means that everyone follows Mashiach. There's a medrash that says that when Mashiach comes, it says regarding Esther Amalka, that Esther Amalka, all the nations, they all said she's from our nation. And it says, and the same thing will be with Mashiach, that every person is going to see in Mashiach his leader, his person, someone who's connected to him. What does that mean and how does that work? What is Mashiach? In short, Mashiach is the Neshama Klalis, the one who reveals inside each Jew his Yechida, his spark of godliness that's inside him. And for this reason, every Jew has to connect to Mashiach, because Mashiach can't just be coming to reveal the Yechida inside some people. Mashiach has to reveal inside every Jew and inside every aspect of the world their yechida, their spark of godliness that's in them, until they themselves want to connect to Hashem. Mashiach is the one person who includes all of those sparks, and therefore he has the ability to reveal in the neshama of every Jew what they really are. And perhaps that's the meaning of the Medrash. Every person is going to look at Mashiach and they're going to see in Mashiach, they're going to see them their own self. Because that's what Mashiach is. Every person is going to be able to look at Mashiach and is going to be able to see what he is. He's going to be able to see his essence of his spark of his neshama and the way he's connected to the Eibishter. And perhaps the Alter Rebbe was answering this person, Minei Uvei. The person asked the Alter Rebbe, Mashiach be a chassid or masnagit. What was he really asking the Alter Rebbe? He was saying, how could you chassidim claim an exclusiveness on the idea of Mashiach? You're cutting the rest of us off. How could you chassidim be claiming Mashiach to be exclusively yours? And the Alter Rebbe answered him, you're missing the whole point of what Mashiach is. And that's where the Alter Rebbe told him, Chassidim are gleibinke, they're believers. Chassidim, when they look at what Mashiach is, they're not looking, he's mine, he's my Rebbe, he belongs to me. When a chassid looks at Mashiach, he sees someone who's beyond him. He sees someone who's totally not him. Because for a chassid, that spark of godliness that's in him is an essence which is beyond him. And therefore the Alter Rebbe said, for a chassid, Mashiach will be a veltisha. The chassid is not going to look at Mashiach and think that Mashiach is me, is my completion, my way, my derech. Why? Because he realizes Mashiach is way beyond him. So he's going to be the veltisha for the chassid. Mashiach will belong to the world. Mashiach will be the one who reveals the spark of godliness into every part of the world. The chassid will see in Mashiach the veltisha, the other one, the one who's revealing elikus into the world. The misnagid is going to see in Mashiach a veltisha. He's going to see someone who's himself. Why? Because he's not a glebike. He's not a believer. He doesn't have that belief where he sees in Mashiach something which is beyond him. For him, he's going to have to see in Mashiach. And like you see clearly, you look at how a chassid looks at the Rebbe and you look at how a misnagid looks at the Rebbe. And it's not to knock the misnagid or to say the misnagid is not good, is good. It's the different ways and the different paths. When a chassid looks at the Rebbe, he sees someone who's beyond me. Someone who I don't grasp, I don't fathom. Someone who brings a lakos into the world, the veltisha, the one who brings a lakos into the world. The misnagid looks at the Rebbe and what does he see? He sees the Weltische. He sees his own worldview. He sees a goyin. He sees a tzaddik. But the goyin and the tzaddik means something that I can relate to. He's such a goyin. He's a gyana goyin. He's the most amazing genius. He's such a tzaddik. He's such a miracle worker. Unbelievable. So the Weltische is both the chassid and the misnagid are going to see in Mashiach a Weltische. The chassid sees in Mashiach the Weltische. He sees in him someone who is beyond me. He's not someone who knows how to learn better than me, who can learn chassidus better than me, who can learn nigla better than me, who's a goyin and a tzaddik and a bal mefes more than me. He sees someone who brings and reveals a lakus in the world who's beyond. He's a glaibik, he's a believer, he believes in someone who's beyond. And the Misnagid looks at Mashiach and he also sees the Weltische. He sees the worldly person who's the goyin, who's the tzaddik, according to my worldviews. And in a sense, it seems that the Alter Rebbe wasn't just saying a gleich vertel. The Alter Rebbe was actually answering his question. His question was, you chassidim are making Mashiach exclusive. And what the Alter Rebbe answered him was, you don't begin to understand what Mashiach is. The Mashiach that you're looking for, the goyin, the tzaddik, that's who you'll see. That's what you're going to connect to. The Mashiach, which is the chassid, knows Mashiach. He's not making him exclusive because the chassid sees someone who's way beyond him, who his whole essence is that he's bringing a lakus into the world. And if you want to look, as we said before, that's actually something. Not only is it not a contradiction to the Rebbe being Mashiach, that actually is what anybody who looks at the Rebbe sees that. The chassid sees in the Rebbe, the Weltische, the one who reveals the lakos in the world. And the Misnagid sees in Mashiach, in the Rebbe, the Weltische, he sees the goyin. He sees the goyin as something which I can relate to, which is where I can connect to, and therefore he's able to connect to that aspect and in that way reveal his yechida in that essence.